On March 29th, 2017, I set up to a journey, which way was not certain. I left my country, my family, my friends, my love, to seek the unknown. I left in silence and took a flight to Toronto, Canada. Toronto, the biggest city in Canada. It was impressive to see these huge modern buildings, gigantic. Anyway, I never was a friend of cities, and I decided to go out to the Niagara Falls. It was really fascinating to see this powerful piece of nature. Back in Toronto, I was walking through the streets with so many questions in my mind. Where do I go now? I don't know. When do I go? I don't know. How do I go? I don't know. Why I am here for? Let's start with that question. Why am I making this journey? To explore the country, the flora and fauna. To meet locals and connect with other people. For Wwoofing. To train my English. To save something which is very valuable to me. To find new ways and ideas. To live out of my backpack again. To travel on a low budget. For hiking. To find out how far I can go with hitchhiking. To be independent and free. To get out of my comfort zone. To let life flow without rush. To sleep outdoors and to live outdoors. To rediscover myself. To be away from home, my everyday life. To find out who am I without my country, without my home, without my language, my relationship, my family, my friends, my job, my wealth, without everything that surrounded me at home, without the progress, without the system, to find a place of true silence and remoteness, to see the true vast wilderness. I needed to get out into life, to pursue adventure. I needed to get out into the West, into the wild.
Thank you.
After 48 hours in the Greyhound bus, crossing the provinces of Ontario, Manitoba and Saskatchewan, I arrived in Calgary, Alberta. From that point, I decided not to spend one more dollar for transportation. Calgary, the city of the 1988 Winter Olympics, and the set location of the movie Cool Runnings. After exploring the city, I signed up for Wwoofing and made an arrangement with my first farm near Rocky Mountain House, about 3 hours north. I was nervous about the hitchhiking, so I first started with a passive strategy. It worked well. On the first day, I had rides, and I made it to Cochrane and slept a night in my tent next to the highway. The next morning, I got a ride to Rocky Mountain House, and I walked to the farm, some kilometers outside of town.
Very nice, well done. Enjoy. I really enjoyed the time on Jeff and Julie's farm. But after 2 weeks, I felt like I had to move again. So I went to Melanie's place some kilometers further.
I got my ticket for the long way round. 2 bottle of whiskey for the way. And I sure would like some sweet company. And I'm leaving tomorrow, what do you say? When I'm I'm fine. gonna miss me by my walk. You're gonna miss me by my talk. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone.
Again, after 2 weeks, I left the farm. And I was heading to Turner Valley, a town south of Calgary, where my next farm was located.
In 61 I went to the war to win one for Virginia. Yeah, my brother went first and they called me too. I was green as clover in the morning dew. So I marched to the drum and we sang to the tune. Carry me back to Virginia. Fire in the cannon, water in the well. Raced through the valley with a rebel yell. I learned that quick how to march like hell. And I fixed that bayonet.
One day, we did a trip to the Dinosaur Provincial Park, 3 hours east. It's a valley with its own microclimate and a remarkable history. A beautiful prairie landscape with unique plants and wildlife. The time on Larry's and Susan's farm was fantastic. After a month, I continued my journey, and I left their farm. It was the beginning of June, when I got a ride to Canmore, the gateway into the Rocky Mountains.
Thank you. I've been around the world in a pouring rain, feeling out of place, really feeling strange. Take me to a place where they know my name, cause I ain't met nobody that looks the same. I'm a fish out of water, lying out of the jungle.
You're a fish out of water, lying out of the jungle.
I need my peoples, my peoples. Take me to my peoples. It's like I'm in heaven. See, I've been traveling forever. But now that I'm home, feels like I'm in heaven. See, I've been traveling forever. But now that I found a home, feels like I'm in heaven. 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 Heaven. Traveling the world like a touring man, been around and planted in them foreign lands. I've seen things that I thought I'd never see. Take me to a place where they look like me. I'm a lion out of jungle, fish out of the ocean.
He's a lion out of the jungle, fish out of the ocean.
I need my peoples, my peoples. Take me to my peoples. Feels like I'm in heaven, feels like I'm in heaven, heaven. Traveling the world like a touring man, been around and planted in them foreign lands. I've seen things that I thought I'd never see. Take me to a place where they look like me. I'm a lion out of jungle, fish out of the ocean.
He's a lion out of the jungle, fish out of the ocean.
I need my peoples, take me to my peoples.
The time in the Rockies was stunning and challenging at the same time. It was July 12th, and I left Alberta and the Rocky Mountains and traveled into British Columbia. I started to hitch a ride in the morning, and I arrived in the town of Hope 16 hours later in the middle of the night. The sky was covered in smoke, and I had a hard time to catching a ride these days. When the wildfires of British Columbia came up, and many highways all across the province were closed. In Hope, my host Graham picked me up, and I helped at his place for a couple of days. The property was close to the Coquihalla Canyon and the Town of Hope, both set locations of the first Rambo movie. We better drop them sails and get inside. When will the weather ever let us go? I guess we'll have to wait until the trade winds blow. We'll be free, 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 free. Don't you wanna be free? From time to time a little free. And I'm I was going on, into the west, hitching a ride to Vancouver, the last part of my trip to the West Coast. It was an amazing feeling to see the Pacific Ocean and to realize the huge distance that was already behind me. After nearly 3 months, I have already had so many adventures. As I reached the West Coast, I was thinking about how I could go on. And I was wondering, if I already made it that far, then how far north could I go? I put out my thumb again, north this time. And Jeff stopped on the highway. He gave me a ride to Whistler, where he hosted me for a couple of days. It was August 2nd, and I was heading further north, to 100 Mile House, where my next farm was located. Due to the wildfires, the direct way on Highway 97 was closed, so I needed to get around this area. It eventually became a long day of hitchhiking. After some wonderful days on Graham and Anita's farm, I continued going north, and I was trying to find rides to Dawson Creek, where the Alaska Highway starts, to get to Whitehorse and the Yukon Territory. It took me 6 days to get there. Long time waiting on the road, and only short rides until Dawson Creek. It was really desperate at some points. But as I always said to myself, also short steps are steps that eventually bring me to my goal. And there is only one road that brings me back home.
Oh, I've been having some hard traveling, I thought you knowed. I've been having some hard traveling way down the road. I've been having some hard traveling, hard rambling, hard gambling, and I've been having some hard traveling long. Oh, I've been riding them blind passengers, I thought you knowed. I've been riding them fast wheelers way down the road. Blind passengers, flat wheelers, dead enders, kicking up cinders, and I've been having some hard traveling, Lord. Oh, I've been working in the hard rock tunnel, I thought you knowed. I've been pouring red hot slag way down the road. I've been blasting, I've been firing, and I've been pouring the red hot iron, and I've been having some hard traveling, Lord. Been hitching on 66 way down the road. Heavy load, worried mind, I'm looking for a woman that's hard to find, and I've been having some hard traveling, Lord. Oh, I've been hitting some hard harvesting, I thought you knowed. North Dakota to Kansas City way down the road. Cutting that wheat and stacking it here, trying to make about a dollar a day, and I've been having some hard traveling, Lord. Oh, I've been locked in the Hard Rock Jail, I thought you knowed. I've been laying out 90 days way down the road. The mean old judge says to me it's 90 days for vagrancy, and I've been hitting some hard traveling, Lord.
I finally made it into the Yukon Territory. In Whitehorse, I took a kayak and paddled down the Yukon River to Carmex. 7 days up north, the river was my steady companion. On the shores, I discovered many old camps and relics of the gold rush. Every day and night, I could feel the spirit of these old times.
Through the dark.
It was an amazing adventure on the Yukon River, and I was glad that I made it back to civilization. In CarMex, I was hitching a ride to famous Dawson City, where the gold rush started in 1897. A wonderful town, where the spirit of those days survived.
I'm headed down south to the land of the pines. I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina, staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers, and I'm hoping for Riley I can see my baby tonight. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Running from the cold up in New England, I was born to be a fiddler in an old time string band. My baby plays a guitar, a big banjo now. All the North Country winters keep forgetting me, and I lost my money playing poker, so I had to up and lay. But I ain't a turning back to live that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, south out of Roanoke, I caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toke. But he's headed west from the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. And I gotta get a move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I die in Raleigh, at least I will die free. So wreck me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me.
Across that crooked river to the valley down below. I was swimming in that water when they came up to the shore, saying, sorry son, this won't be dry land here anymore. Yes, in my hometown, it's a half mile down, it's a half mile of water all around, all around. My hometown is a half mile down. Their plans to flood that peaceful valley just to build Watauga Dam. Oh, they brought in their bulldozers and pushed our homes away, and they handed me a shovel and 60 cents a day, singing my that rose up on that day by the banks of the old Watauga, where I once used to play. Yes, I look out on that water where they made their big mistake and covered up our hometown neath the godforsaken lake. Singing, my hometown is a half mile down. It's a half mile of water all around, all around. My hometown is a half mile down. It's a half mile of water all around, all around. My hometown is a half mile down.
It's the end of August. The nights were getting cold in the tent, and the last part of Canada was ahead. It was only 105 kilometers west on the top of the world highway to the Alaskan border. It's a lonesome highway, with just a car now and then, but a breathtaking view of a colorful wilderness as far as the eye can see. I walked quite a distance, and hitching a ride was hard. But I was eventually lucky, and I made it to the border in 2 days. I had a hard time at customs when I showed up on foot. But at the end, I got a US visa for only 1 month. My travel plans changed with that, and suddenly, there was a foreseeable end of this long journey ahead. At first it was sad, but after thinking about the situation for some days, it felt right. I had already made it that far, and the journey is going to end where it's supposed to be. And I still had enough time to go to the very end. From the border, it was another 500 kilometers to Fairbanks. Hitchhiking became a routine. I made it to Fairbanks and decided to spend a few days there before I went on. It blows my mind every time I'm thinking about how far I had already made it, how many people I had already met, how many incredible things I had experienced, and it was not the end at all. I'm in Alaska now, and it's hard to know what awaits me in this last frontier.
I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. yeah, man, I've been everywhere. I've been everywhere.
Weeks before, I had found out that there is only one highway that goes further up north. It is called the Dalton Highway that goes to Dead Horse and the Arctic Ocean. I found Lazar, who was interested in making a road trip there, so we shared a rental car and drove 800 kilometers up north through the Arctic tundra to the very end of this continent.
Raising our torches and fighting the demons, darling, don't.
In the evening, the Arctic showed me one of its most beautiful sunsets. And after 14 hours driving, the road suddenly ended. There was the Arctic Ocean. It's hard to describe the feeling of being here, at the very end, after thousands of kilometers of hitchhiking and walking. The misty sky revealed a magical rainbow. It was like the Arctic realm welcomed me with a gift. Because finally, after all these struggles, I made it to the end. The end of this continent. I was heading back to Fairbanks and into my next adventure. I got right south to Healy, where the Stampede Trail starts. The trail that brought Alexander Supertramp to the Magic Bus, where he never returned. This is my final survival test. I now walk into the wild. Hello, Bridget. After a month crossing this huge country, it seems I've reached the very end of this continent. Since I came here, I never before in my life was exposed to more sun. I never was closer to the elements for such a long time. And I never before was closer to Mother Nature. I'm going through a remote wilderness, where it seems that there is no meaning of time in this place. It feels vast and wild, and it's quiet and lonesome, as it never was before. I was looking for Alaska, and I found it at the end. Happiness is only real when shared.
Leo Supertramp.
Beside her, I am the better man. When I look to leave her, I always stagger back again. Once I built an ivory tower so I could worship from above. When I climbed down to be set free, she took me in again. There's a big hot sun. By my side, when I try to understand, she just opens up her hands. Bound down and flew away the hours of her garden and her sun.
So I tried to warn her. I turned to see her weep. 40 days and 40 nights, and it's still coming down, babe. There's a big heart, son, beating on the big people in the big heart world. Oh, there's a big heart, son, beating on the big people in the big heart world. Oh, there's a big heart, son, beating on the big people in the big heart world. Oh, there's a big heart, son, beating on the big people.
I made it to the magic bus and back to civilization. From Healy, it was not far to Denali National Park. My body was weak, and the nights were cold and wet. But I knew that these were my last weeks of my backpacking life, and the end of this long journey was coming closer.
The woods are quiet in this part of town.
It was the end of September, and I had already booked a flight back home. There it was now, the last night in the tent. And then the following morning, I left the wild, after a long journey. I hitched a ride for the last time, and I was heading to Anchorage, where I spent the last 3 days in a hostel to recover. These days gave me time to think back about my journey. It was an incredible experience, adventurous, funny, exhausting, and life-changing at the same time. I did explore the country, its flora and fauna, further than I ever believed possible at the beginning, from east to west and to the furthest north. I met uncountable locals and connected to so many different people on my way. I was woofing on 5 farms in Alberta and British Columbia. I practiced and refined my English a lot. I found so many new ideas and ways for my future. I was completely independent and free. I let life flow without rush. I lived out of my backpack for 6 months, and I saw it as a symbol of property. Everything I loaded more in it made me heavier, a burden for body and mind. For 6 months, I lived out of my backpack, and I never needed more than that. My mind was free of everything else. I walked and hiked over 1,600 kilometers. I hitchhiked over 9,300 kilometers and rode 4,500 kilometers via bus. I paddled 320 kilometers in a kayak on the Yukon River. I slept outdoors in a tent more nights than in an actual bed. I found many more places of true silence and remoteness than I ever thought possible. I've seen the endless true wilderness. I didn't have an easy time out in the wild. But for me, suffering was also necessary to experience happiness at the end. Because life happens when you're out of your comfort zone. And if you're out of your comfort zone for such a long time, you appreciate everything much more. A warm and cozy bed, a warm meal, a warm shower, or just to feel safe. At the end, I was weary of all the adventures, of living out of my backpack and living in the wild. But I didn't regret a single day. Everything happens for a reason, and it was time to go back home. I have already had so many adventures and stories to tell. I can ask no more. I'm so grateful for everyone who was part of my journey and everything that happened to me in that time. Canada became like a second home for me. And someday, I want to come back. I needed the journey. I needed the adventures. I need nature. Big, mysterious, wild. To find myself and lose myself. And find myself again. To rewrite the definition of progress and wealth. And be reminded what it meant to be truly alive.
Without me. less is more. But if less is more, how you keeping score? It means for every point you make, your level drops. Kinda like you're starting from the top. And you can't do that. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, crazy indeed. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, have mercy on me. I hope you're not angry if I disagree. Society, crazy indeed.